Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
God been good to you?
Amen. Yes, he is.
Listen, if we're able to be in the house of God tonight, God's been good to us.
Yes, sir.
Praise God. Praise God. Good to see each one of you here to worship God tonight. Praise God. Praise God. Going to a familiar song. As a matter of fact, I think I used it about couple messages ago, and that's Psalms 23. I know you're standing there wondering, how many messages can you get out of Psalms 23?
A lot of them.
Praise God. So Psalms 23, verses 1 through 6, said, "The Lord is my shepherd. The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. He maketh me to lie down in green pastures. He leadeth me beside the still waters. He restoreth my soul. He leadeth me in the paths of righteousness for his name's sake. Yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil. For thou art with me, thy rod and thy staff, they comfort me. Thou preparest a table before me in the presence of mine enemies. Thou anointest my head with oil, my cup runneth over. Surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life, and I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever." Praise God. Praise him one more time. God, we love you. God, we praise you for being so good to us, Lord. We praise you, God. Lord, for all your blessings, Lord. We ask, God, that you just anoint us and use us for thy glory. Anoint hearts and ears to receive your word tonight. We'll praise you in Jesus' name. Praise God. You may be seated. I want to go back to take my thought from verse 5. So thou preparest a table before me in the presence of mine enemies. Thou anointest my head with oil. My cup runneth over. Just a little while, I want to speak to us tonight on my cup. My cup. Mm-hmm. He said, my cup runneth over. Now, if you look at the word cup translated from the Hebrew and the Greek, it literally, is a cup like to drink out of. You know, that's one of the meanings you find through the Bible. But then you begin to look and you find figuratively, it's a lot of times it has to do with what the contents of the cup is. For instance, in the New Testament, Jesus said that the cup, they were about to partake of the Last Supper. And, you know, they took the cup of wine, and then, you know, they passed it around the ring. He told them, he said, you drink, because this is the cup of New Testament, of the New Testament. He said, this is the cup of the New Testament of my blood. So you see, a lot of times it's talking about the contents in the cup. So you can look at it several ways. And there's several different times that, well, throughout the Bible, that the word cup is used in different meanings. For instance, in one place in the book of Isaiah, it talks about the cup of his fury or his wrath. Then it talks about in Matthew's Gospel, 26th chapter, you find that the cup that Jesus had to bear was a cup of suffering. But then in Psalms 23 and 5, when the psalmist wrote, he said, my cup runneth over, he was talking about a cup of blessings.
Amen.
A cup of refreshing water. He said, my cup runneth over. He was talking about the blessings of God. Now, I don't know about you, but I want my cup to run over with the blessings of God.
Yes, amen.
Huh?
Amen.
You know, I begin to think of all the things that we may need in life, and what we need more than anything is our cup to be running over with the Spirit of God.
Yeah.
Throughout the Word of God, especially in the book of Acts, you find, even starting with Acts, the second chapter, the Bible says they were filled with the Holy Ghost.
Amen.
They talk about Stephen, and talk about some of the others in the book of Acts, talking about them being full of the Holy Ghost. So if I'm full of the Spirit of God, you know, I want to be full to the point it's running over.
Amen.
And when I'm full of that, there's not room for much anything else.
Mm-hmm.
So he said, my cup runneth over. If somehow we could get our focus on holding just as much of God as we can.
Yes, sir.
It would move a lot of things out of our life that shouldn't be in our life.
Amen.
Let our cup run over.
Right.
Let our cup run over. David, you know, talk about the Lord being his shepherd and providing him with the green pastures and leading him beside the still waters. And finally he said, thou preparest a table before me in the presence of mine enemies. Thou anointest my head with oil. That anointing, that oil represents the Holy Ghost or represents the Spirit of God. Thou anointest my head with oil, my cup runneth over.
Amen.
If you study that, oil represents the Spirit of God. You know, the Holy Ghost.
Yes, sir.
He said, thou anointest my head with oil, my cup runneth over. My cup runneth over. Then he said, surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life, and I'll dwell in the house of the Lord forever. My desire is going to be in the house of the Lord if my cup's running over.
Yes, sir.
Praise God. Praise God. So we find a blessing there. But look upon that Psalms 11:6, what it says. It said, upon the wicked he shall rain snares, fire, and brimstone, and a horrible tempest. Then he said, this shall be the portion of their cup. This shall be the portion of their cup. So you find in one place it talks about a cup of blessing. In another place it's a cup of judgment for the wicked. For the wicked. Praise God. Look at Psalm 16. Psalm 16, verse 5. It said, the Lord is the portion of my inheritance and of my cup. Now, what's your cup full of tonight?
All right.
Mm-hmm. What's your cup full of? The Lord is the portion of my inheritance and of my cup. Then he said, thou maintainest my life.
Amen.
The lines are fallen unto me in pleasant places. Yea, I have a goodly heritage. I will bless the Lord who hath given me counsel. My reins also instruct me in the night session. I have set the Lord always before me. Because he is at my right hand, I shall not be moved. Therefore my heart is glad. And my glory rejoiceth. My flesh also shall rest in hope. Sound like his cup's running over.
Mm-hmm.
For thou wilt not leave my soul in hell, neither will thou suffer thine Holy One to see corruption. Thou wilt show me the path of life. In thy presence is fullness of joy. At thy right hand there are pleasures forevermore. No, there is no wonder that God's people long to be in his presence.
Amen.
There's no wonder. God's people, Bible said, blessed is he who hungers and thirsts after righteousness, for he shall be fulfilled. There's no wonder that we crave being in the presence of God. We crave coming to the house of God and feeling the Spirit of God poured out upon us. Why?
Amen.
Because in his presence is fullness of joy.
Right.
I don't know about you, but I like the feeling of fullness of joy.
Right.
Yep.
And if it's full, it's going beyond the point of full till it's running over.
Right.
It runs over, that fullness of joy. That fullness of joy. So he said, he'll show me the path of life. In thy presence, fullness of joy. He said, he's the portion of my cup. He's the portion of my cup. Praise God. Praise God. Look at Psalm 75, though. Psalm 75. Verse 6. For promotion cometh neither from the east, nor from the west, nor from the south, but God is the judge. Now, what you know, God is the judge. He putteth down one and setteth up another.
Amen.
We talked about this, I think, a little bit in Sunday school class Sunday morning about you know, God can put a leader in place or he can take a leader down out of place.
Yes, he can.
He's the judge. For promotion cometh, the promotion comes from God.
Amen.
So, he said, now look at verse 8. For in the hand of the Lord there is a cup, and the wine is red. It is full of mixture, and he poureth out of the same, out of that cup. Out of that cup. It's a mixture. He said, but the dregs thereof, and that's what settles in the bottom, you know, all the wicked of the earth shall wring them out and drink them. And if you'll study it out, in another place he talks about the dregs. He's talking about the judgment of God or the wrath of God to be poured out. He said the wicked's going to drink of that. And then he said, but I'll declare forever, I will sing praises to the God of Jacob. All the horns of the wicked also will I cut off, but the horns of the righteous shall be exalted. So, so you see, in the hand of God, there's a cup. I've said it's full of mixture. It pours out the judgment of God. You know, it can pour you out a blessing, or it can pour you out a curse. Huh? Blessing for the righteous, a curse for the wicked. All right, look at Psalms 116. It said, what shall I render unto the Lord for all his benefits toward me? How many know when you serve God, there's benefits?
Yes, sir.
There's benefits in serving God. He said, what shall I render unto the Lord for all his benefits toward me? I will take the cup of salvation.
Amen.
I believe that's what I'll say. I'll take the cup of salvation and call upon the name of the Lord. Yeah, I believe I'll just take the cup of salvation.
Yes, sir.
I don't want to take the cup of his fury or the cup of his wrath.
No.
But I'll take the cup of his salvation and call upon the name of the Lord. He said, I'll pay my vows unto the Lord now in the presence of all his people. I'll pay my vows. I'll pay my vows in the presence of the Lord. Or unto the Lord. Look. I'll take up a cup of salvation. I'll call upon the name of the Lord. I'll pay my vows unto the Lord. So I said, what's a vow? Let's say, God, if you'll do this for me, I'll do this for you. If you'll save me, God, I'll live for you. If you'll save me, God, I'll stand for you. God, if you'll fill me with your spirit, I'll work for you. I'll do something for you. So when you do, when you've done that, you've made a vow to God.
Amen.
And the Bible teaches that it's best if you pay your vows. So he said, I'll pay my vows unto the Lord now in the presence of all his people. See, sometimes we're quick to say, God, I'll live for you until that cup gets a little bit bitter. You know, we go through a trial or we go through trouble. But we've got to pay our vows. We've got to pay our vows unto God. Sometimes our cup is full of God's blessings. And sometimes it's not so pleasant to drink from. Somebody said, what do you mean? Jesus had a cup to bear.
Yes, it is.
Huh?
Yes, it did.
And he was facing that in the Garden of Gethsemane. And he got down and he prayed, the Bible said, until his sweat became as great drops of blood. Mm-hmm. He prayed, Father, if it be thy will, let this cup pass from me.
Yes, it did.
Huh?
Mm-hmm.
But God had a plan for it. Somebody said, I want to be in God's will. We all do.
Amen.
But sometimes it's not a pleasant cup that we have to drink. Jesus was fulfilling the will of God.
Amen.
But he faced a crucifixion and he knew what he faced.
Mm.
He said, Father, if it be possible, let this cup pass from me. But finally, and here's where we find our victory when we learn how to pray through in the garden.
Mm-hmm.
When we learn how to pray through in the garden, here's where we find our victory. Nevertheless, not my will, but thine be done.
Mm-hmm.
Thine be done. I think we need a little more going by the garden.
That's right.
That's how we overcome self. That's how we overcome the flesh. That's how we overcome temptation.
Mm-hmm.
We go by the garden.
Mm-hmm.
Until it's not our will anymore, but it's his will. Look at Mark the 10th chapter. Mark the 10th chapter, verse 35. And James and John, the sons of Zebedee, came unto him, saying, Master, we would that thou shouldest do for us whatsoever we will desire. Huh? Or we shall desire. He said, you know, we want you to do for us whatever we desire. That's pretty bold of them, wouldn't it?
Amen.
But look what he asked them. He said unto them, what would you that I should do for you? And they said unto him, grant unto us that we may sit, one on thy right hand and the other on thy left hand, in thy glory.
Mm-hmm.
But Jesus said unto them, you know not what you ask. Can you drink of the cup that I drink of?
Mm-hmm.
Look what he asked them. You drink of the cup that I drink of? For Jesus knew what he was facing. He knew right then it wasn't going to be a pleasant cup. But it would turn into a cup of blessing.
Yes, sir.
Wait a minute. Right then it was going to be a bitter cup that he was going to have to drink. But it would turn into a cup of blessing for everybody. For everybody. He said, know you not what you ask? Can you drink of the cup that I drink of and be baptized with the baptism that I'm baptized with? And they said unto him, we can. Sometimes we say we can until that cup gets bitter. But Jesus said unto them, you shall indeed drink of the cup that I drink of. And with the baptism that I'm baptized withal, shall you be baptized.
Mm-hmm.
But to sit on my right hand and on my left hand is not mine to give, but it shall be given to them for whom it is prepared. He said, yeah, you're going to drink. You can't. They said, we can't. He said, yep. You'll drink of the cup that I drink of. You'll be baptized with the baptism that I'm baptized with. Of course, they were there in the upper room, got baptized with the Holy Ghost.
Mm-hmm.
But they also died a martyr's death.
That's right.
Except John. James did. John. They tried to kill him. They finally had to exile him. And look. Look at 1 Corinthians. So are we willing? Are we willing to drink of the cup that Jesus drank of? He said, if any man will come after me, let him deny himself, take up his cross and follow me. That cross was what was the cup that Jesus was going to have to drink of. And he said, if any man will come after me, let him deny himself, take up his cross and follow me.
Amen.
Look at 1 Corinthians. 1 Corinthians, 10th chapter. Verse 21. You cannot drink the cup of the Lord and the cup of devils. You cannot be partakers of the Lord's table and of the table of devils. In other words, we call it, you can't straddle the fence. Right? Mm-hmm. Do we provoke the Lord to jealousy? Are we stronger than He? All things are, Paul's right. He said, all things are lawful to me, but all things are not expedient. In other words, not good. See, all things, there's a lot of things that are lawful now. But just as full of the devil and full of the sin as it can be. Right? They're lawful. Paul said it's lawful for me, but it's not expedient. See, there's laws passed. You know, it's lawful for a woman to get an abortion. But it's not right.
No.
According to God's word.
Amen.
See, just cause everybody else is doing it and saying it's all right doesn't mean it's right. And he said, all things are lawful for me. All things are lawful for me, but all things edify not. Sometimes we need to ask ourselves, you know, quit trying to drink out of both sides of the cup. Is that the old saying? And, you know, from God's cup to the devil's cup. So all things are lawful. Paul said all things are lawful to me, but all things edify not. So we need to ask ourselves, when we start to do something, whatever it might be, maybe go somewhere or do something or participate in some kind of activity, whatever the case might be, first thing we've got to ask ourselves, does it edify my walk with God? Does it edify my walk with God? Paul said, it's lawful for me, but all things edify not. So, you know, those are the decisions that we face every day. Huh? It just every law that's passed now, almost, or well up until, we'll have to wait and see what this administration does. But everything that seemingly almost every time you turn around, they're passing a law that tears down the Christian values.
Yeah.
It's lawful, but it doesn't edify. Finally, in Matthew 23, verse 25, he said, woe to you, scribes and Pharisees and hypocrites, for you make clean the outside of the cup, not the platter, but within they are full of extortion and excess.
Mm.
You may clean the outside of the tub. Could I guarantee you one thing? That if you take care of the inside of the cup and clean it up, that the outside's going to take care of itself.
Yeah, right. Mm-hmm.
Hmm?
Mm-hmm.
That's what he said, thou blind Pharisee, cleanse first that which is within. What does the Bible tell us to do? Seek ye first the kingdom of God and his righteousness, and these things shall be added unto you. What things? When he was talking about that, he was talking about the food, raiment, what we put on, you know, all these things that the Gentiles seek after, you see. Clean first that which is within, the cup and the platter, that the outside of them may be clean also. May be clean also. My cup.
Mm-hmm.
What's my cup full of? I want to be like David. I want to be able to write down, the Lord is my shepherd. My cup runneth over. Right?
Mm-hmm.
The Lord is my shepherd. My cup runneth over. And surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life.
Amen.
And I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever.
Thank you, Jesus.
See, even David, way back then, knew you were supposed to be faithful to the house of God.
Mm-hmm.
That's right.
He said, I'll dwell in the house of the Lord forever.
Mm-hmm.
Praise God. Lord, let my cup, let my cup run over with your blessings.
Mm-hmm.
Praise God. How do I let my cup run over with the blessings of God? I keep it clean. I keep it clean.
Mm-hmm.
Praise God. My cup. We've all got a cup to bear. He was talking about two cups here. The cup of the Lord and the cup of the devil.
Amen.
We're going to drink from one of those two cups.
Mm-hmm.
I'd rather drink from that well of living water. I'd rather
drink
to be in my cup. Praise God, so my cup will run over.
Mm-hmm.
That's all I was saying. Keep your cup clean, keep it full of the Spirit of God. Keep your cup clean, keep it full of the Spirit of God.
Amen.
Praise God. Praise God. Concentrate. Listen, we worry about all kind of things. We worry about doing all kind of things. And we worry about this and we worry about that and how this going to work out and how that's going to work out.
Mm-hmm.
Could I tell you this? I'm going to repeat it. I've already said it. Get the cup full of the Spirit of God. Seek first the kingdom of God. Get that soul taken care of.
Yes.
Get yourself taken care of in the Lord. Get it full. Keep it full. These other things that you're worried about are falling in place?
Yes, it will.
Huh?
Yes, it will.
Take care of that part first. Always, always, always take care of the spiritual first.
Amen.
And the rest will fall in place. Praise God. You come back Sunday morning worshiping God. See what God's going to do.